principle. Then the Shruti proceeds to show how what we call nama is the cause of this nama, or the nama or the name arises from vāk. Vāk means the speech. And here it is interpreted as shabda samanyam. From the shabda, meaning the sound, arises all the names. So creation which consists of names is nothing but sound. This vāk, the speech, is indeed the uktam, the cause, the material cause of the names. So from this vāk, or the speech meaning shabda samanyam, from the shabda, etāni nāmāni, sarvāni nāmāni uttiṣṭhanti, all the names arise from shabda, naturally. Etadeṣām sāma. That shabda alone is called sāma of all the names. Va etad di sarvaihi nāmabihi samam. Because in all the names, this sound of shabda is samam, is equally present. Etadeṣām brahma. In fact, this shabda is brahma, or the ātma of all the names. Because etadhi sarvani nāmāni vibharati. Because it is shabda that sustains all the names, and therefore it is the very ātma. So three reasons were advanced to show how shabda is the very cause of noun, names, and then what we call the names are nothing but shabda. Because it is kārya kārana sambandha. Shabda is kāranam, the nāma is kārya, and therefore the kārya cannot obtain apart from the kāranam, and therefore what we call nāma is not really different from shabda. Then other is sāmanya viśeṣa sambandha. Because shabda is sāmanya and all the noun names are viśeṣa. So nāma viśeṣa, like devadatta, yajñadatta, all these different specific names are nothing but the modifications of the same. Modification means the particulars. The particulars of what we call shabda. So shabda is sāmanya, the universal, and a given name is a particular of that sāmanya. Answer is that what we call the nāma or the names derive their existence from shabda. Shabda is the very ātma, provides them the satta and the sūrti. And therefore ātma-lābha, the very existence of all the names is possible because of shabda. And therefore also we say that they are not different from shabda. And thus, this passage showed us how what we call nāma are not apart from shabda. Then second passage said, what about rūpa? Atha rūpānām cakṣuhu uktam. So what we call rūpa, or all the forms or colors, are nothing but cakṣuhu, means eyes. So what is meant by that's the passage that we are reading on the page 410. Atha idānīm rūpānām sitāsita prabhatīnām cakṣuhu iti cakṣur viṣaya sāmānyam cakṣur śabdā abhidhayam rūpa sāmānyam prakāśya mātram abhidhiyate sitāsita prabhatīnām. So white and black and all these different colors are there. Of all these colors are rūpa cakṣuhu iti. It's nothing but cakṣuhu. What we call rūpa are nothing but cakṣuhu. So very interesting way of looking at things. But what we call rūpa, or the forms or colors, are none other than cakṣu, or the eyes. What is meant by cakṣu? Cakṣur viṣaya sāmānyam. So, cakṣu, or the eyes, also perceive something that is sāmānya, universal, and perceive that which is particular. So that is what we call rūpa sāmānyam, a color, universal color, which forms the basis of all the colors. Just as there is shabda samanyam, meaning there is a sound in general, which forms the basis of all particular sounds. Like gold is general, which forms the basis of all the ornaments. And so also, there is rupa samanyam. There is what we call color, universal color, or the principle of color, let us put it this way. So principle of noun is the sound. The principle of color forms the very basis of every specific color. And that is what is meant here by the word cakṣuhu, because eyes are of the nature of the principle of color, and therefore they are able to perceive specific colors. This is how it is understood here. Cakṣur viṣaya sāmānyam cakṣur śabdā abhidhayam rūpa sāmānyam prakasya matram avidiyate. So rupa samanyam, that principle of rupa or the color. Prakasya matram, anything and everything that is illumined, then what happens is karya matram. See on the page 410, footnote number 3 it gives some understanding about this. Rupa samanyam iti. Rupanam chakshuhu uktam iti yatra. Uktam means cause. Rupanam chakshuhu uktam. Of all the rupa or the colors, the chakshu, the eyes, is uktam, is the samanyaka, is the karanam. Upadana karanam. Iti yatra rupa visheshanam karyatvam chakshusaha karanatvam iti. So when this Shruti says that rupanam chakshuhu, it yedat esham uktam, when it says that what we call chakshu is the uktam or the material cause of all the rupa. Then rupa visheshanam karyatvam, all specific rupa become the karya, become the products of the effects. Chakshusaya karanatvam. And chakshu, whatever is referred to as chakshu, it becomes karanam. So we want to know what is it that the Shruti means by when the Shruti uses the word chakshuhu. Chakshuhu normally means eyes. But here, in what sense is the word chakshuhu used? So that idea is being explored. Rupa visheshanam karyatvam. When it said that the chakshu is a cause, then all the specific rupas or the colors are karya and chakshu becomes karanam. Idi karya karana bhava sambandha darshanat. So thus when we find that karya karana bhava being presented here by the Shruti, rupa samanyam chakshuhu yuktam. Therefore, the word chakshu should mean rupa samanyam. Because vishesha is always a karya of samanya. Or samanya is karanam of vishesha. Prasiddhat chakshusaha rupa vishesha anutpattehe. You cannot say that prasiddha chakshuhu, eyes, that as we understand, chakshu means eyes, that is not the cause of the colors. So specific colors are not born of the eyes. Here it says that eyes or chakshu is there from which all the specific colors are born. Therefore we have to say that what is meant here by the word chakshuhu is rupa samanyam or the principle of color, universal color, whatever. Rupa samanyacha samanyacha tad visheshotpatteh ishtatvat. Whereas it's only proper that rupa vishesha or specific colors are born of color in general. Therefore chakshuhu should mean rupa samanyam. Chakshusaha rupamatra tejo vikaratvena rupatmatva. Because chakshu or the eyes are said to be a product of the element tejaha, the element fire. So how the five organs of perception are products of the corresponding five elements, the sattva aspect of the tanmatra, the subtle elements. So from the sattva aspect of the element akasha are formed the organ of hearing. So the sattva aspect of the element vayu is formed the organ of touch. So the sattva aspect of the element fire are formed the eyes. So it is said here, chakshusha rupamatra tejo vikaratvena. So teja means light, which is called rupa. So light meaning the principle of light, the principle of fire. So light is the nature of fire. And so that is why it is that rupamatra tejo vikaratvena. So tejas or the light is rupamatram. And eyes are said to be the products of this principle of light. Therefore, rupatmatvat. So eyes are also of the nature of rupa, meaning the color. Chakshu shabdena rupa samanya graham iti bhavaha. And therefore, by the word chakshu, we understand rupa samanyam or the color in general. Because that is what the eyes are made of. Or that's what the eyes are. This we can say that, that's why vaak, speech, was interpreted as shabda samanyam. Not the organ of speech, but the sound in general. And so also chakshuhu is interpreted as rupa samanyam. Chakshushaha rupatmatvam upapadaram vartike. In the vartika, the chakshu is rupatmatvam. Chakshu is the nature of rupa, is what is upapadaram. So is what is said with logical, you know. Logical reason is given in the vartika to show how what is meant by chakshu is rupa samanyam. Yadyat nirupyate kinchita shabdas prasadikam dhya tattad rupa mirignyam tejasattva visheshataha. This is a big jump. It says here, yadyadhi rupyade kinchit shabdas prasadikam dhya. Dhya by the buddhi, yadyad kinchit rupyade. So whatever the buddhi actually perceives, tatad rupam, that should be understood as rupam. So what rupa also is not confined merely to color, but it is said that whatever the mind perceives, that should be understood as rupam. Why is it so? Tejasattva visheshataha. Because whatever is perceived with the organs by mind, through the organs of perception, all of that is nothing but product of the product of tejaha, or product of the element fire. Tvastrameva hi sarvatra tejo rupad lakshanam. So tvastram, meaning born of tvastru, that is sun. So that is one of the meanings of the word tvastru. Sarvatra tejaha rupad lakshanam. So tejaha, the light, rupad lakshanam, which is the nature of rupa. So everywhere we find everything is a product of the sunlight. Sunlight is the principle of light. Tasmad vishaya samanyam chakshus shabdena bhanyate. And therefore, when the Shruti uses the word chakshuhu, what is meant is what? The vishaya samanyam, in general, whatever is perceived is understood as chakshuhu. See, Tikakara explains that buddhya rupyamane arthe rupa shabda pravrutehe auchitya dyotanartha hi shabdaha. Buddhya rupyamane arthe, so whatever is perceived by buddhi, rupa shabda pravrutehe auchityat, so yadyad hi rupyate, that what he shows prasiddhi, that is only right or it's only proper, that whatever the mind perceives should be called rupa. Rupyamana karyamatrasya rupatva hetumaha. So how do you say that anything that is perceived is called rupa? So tejasattva avisheshataha. Because whatever is perceived with organs of perception is not apart from tejasattva, meaning is not apart from light. How do you say? Karyamatrasya tejasattva avisheshat tasya cha rupatmatva svikarat ityartha. Karyamatrasya, anything that is produced, tejasattva avisheshat, is nothing but a modification of tejaha, modification of light. Tasya cha rupatmatva svikarat ityartha. And what we call tejas, tejas is nothing but rupa, and therefore, whatever is produced from tejas, and tejas means, or light, means rupa, and therefore, whatever is produced or whatever is perceived is nothing apart from rupa, or light. Katham karyamatrasya tejasattvam. How do you say that whatever is karya or whatever is produced is tejasattvam, is nothing but a product of light? How do you say that? Then, tvastram. Tvastram eva hi sarvatra tejo rupad lakshanam. Says the Tika, sarvam hi karyam savitrine tejasa pachyamanam atmanam labhate. So whatever is produced, see, the whole creation is product of food ultimately. Whatever is produced from food. And food is that which is only produced because of sunlight, cooked by sunlight. Sarvam hi karyam savitrine tejasa pachyamanam. So only when everything is cooked by the light of fire, light of sun, this was brought up earlier. In the earlier discussion also, in discussion of the Anna, this was brought up as to how all this food is in fact cooked by sun, and therefore without the sun food could not be. Inasmuch as the entire creation is a product of food, so we say that whatever is created is nothing but the body is cooked by sunlight or is modification of sunlight. The whole earth is a modification of sunlight anyway, this we know. They knew it in their own way, but anyway, we know today that earth is nothing but a product of sun, is nothing but a solidification of sunlight. And so somebody said it very well, that all these people who are moving and all whatever is moving here is nothing but the moving sunlight, you know. Because all of this is modification of sunlight. So sunlight moving and sunlight talking to sunlight, that is precisely what it is. And therefore it is said here, that whatever is created, whatever is perceived, is nothing but the product of, is nothing but the manifestation of sunlight or product of sunlight, and sunlight means principle of light, That means the rupam, never. Whatever is perceived is rupam. So by the word rupa or chakshuhu is meant here, karya matram, anything that is karya or anything that is created. Tathacha tadevatat ityartha. Tathacha, and therefore tadevatat, the savitram tejahaiva karyam. It is the sunlight itself, is whatever karya is nothing but the sunlight. Chakshusha tejasatvena rupatmatvam uktva paritamaha. So when you say that, since chakshuhu or anything that is karyam, anything karyamatram is tejasatvam, has tejas meaning, is a modification of tejas. Having said that, paritamaha, therefore paritamaha is tasmat vishaya samanyam chakshu shabdena bhanyate. So vartikara says that by the word chakshu, shruti means here vishaya samanyam. So whatever is created or whatever is perceived is what is meant here by the word chakshuhu. Etena prakashya matram iti bhashyam vyakhyatam. So all these vartikas actually explain that word from the bhashya, prakashya matram. So bhashyakara said chakshuhu iti chakshu vishaya samanyam chakshu shabda abhideyam rupa samanyam prakashya matram abhidiyate. Prakashya, that is illumined. Prakashaka, illuminator. So prakashya, whatever is illumined, illumined by the sense organs, illumined by the mind, meaning this, the karya matram, whatever is created, all of that is nothing but chakshuhu. So says Anandagiri, chakshuhu iti chakshu shabda abhidayam chakshur vishe samanyam abhidiyate. So by the word chakshuhu iti chakshu shabda abhidayam, so whatever is indicated by the word chakshu, chakshur vishe samanyam abhidiyate, and whatever is perceived by the eyes, in fact whatever is perceived by the sense organ, is in karya matram, the product or effect in general, is what is meant by the word chakshuhu. Tachya rupa samanyam tadavi prakashya matram iti yojana. It's called rupa samanyam, the principle of rupa or the light, which is prakashyam, whatever is illumined or whatever is perceived, is what is meant here by the rupa. And so Vahasya said, atohi sarvani rupani uttishthanti eda desham sama eda disarvahi rupahi samam eda desham brahma etaddi sarvani rupani vibharati. All of this is to be explained as before. So just as shabda was the cause, the material cause of the nama was samanya and the nama was vishesha, shabda was atma and the nama gained its existence from shabda, so also here what we call chakshu or the rupa samanya is the material cause of all the, so rupa vishesha, what we perceive are rupa vishesha, what we perceive are specific rupa, specific forms, specific colors. See, color in general we cannot perceive, because the perceiver itself is color in general. Eyes themselves are nothing but the principle of light. So, the colorless color we cannot perceive. Sort of, you know. Only when the color becomes manifest as specific colors. So when principle of color becomes manifest as specific colors, then alone they can be perceived by the eyes. Therefore, eyes becomes what? Rupa samanyam. And what is perceived is rupa visheshayam. What is perceived are the particular colors, and what perceives is the principle of color. So samanya karana karya, samanya vishesha, atma and what is it? That which gains the atma labha, satta, and that which gains its existence. And that is how that relationship, that is why what we call the rupam is nothing but chakshuhu or rupa samanyam. Now continuing with page 411, the third and the last kandika of this brahmana says, atha karmana atmetyetat esha muktam atohi sarvani karmanyuttishthande etadesham sama etaddi sarvaih karma bhissamam etadesham brahma etaddi sarvani karmani vibharti tadetatrayam sada ekam ayam atma atma o ekasan etatrayam tadetadamrutam satyena channam prava amrutam nama rupe satyam tabhyamayam pranasthannah adha karmana. Now talking about karma, nama, rupa and karma. Adha karmana, of the karma or what we call now the action, atma etyetat esha muktam. Atma here means body. So what atma is body here. And body also means karma samanyam again. Samanyam, karma samanyam. Because it will be explained, in performance of any karma or action, body is invariably involved. And therefore, what is meant by the word body or atma is karma samanyam, the principle of karma, which becomes the cause of the specific karma. Etadesham uktam atohi sarvani karmani uttishtanti. From the body, or from what we call the karma samanyam, principle of karma, sarvani karmani uttishtanti, all the karmas actually arise from that. Etadesham sama, what we call the atma, or the body, or the karma samanyam is sama, is called sama. Because etadhi sarvahi karma bhi samam, because it is samam, equally present in every karma. Etadesham brahma, and this again, what we call karma samanya is the atma of all the karma. Etaddi sarvani karmani vibharati, because it sustains or upholds all specific karma. Same kind of, same thing. Thus, having said how the creation is nothing but nama rupa karma, and that is also nothing but the vag, and what is it, the chakshuhu, and atma or the body. Then it said, tadetatrayam, trayam sat ekam ayam atma. This nama, rupa and karma, in spite of its being three, is in fact only one alone, namely atma, the body. Atma u ekasan etatrayam, and the body in spite of being one, is this three. Etadamrutam satyena chinnam. So, what is amrutam? Amrutam nama rupe. Nama rupe satyam pranava amrutam. So prana is said to be amruta, nama rupa is said to be satya. Edad amrutam satyena chinnam. This prana is actually concealed by the name and form. So he said that this amrutam is satyena chinnam. Satya is nama rupa and amruta is prana. Tabhyamayam prana chinnah. By these two names and forms, the prana is concealed here, is covered. Okay, now we can go to rupa prakrana anantaryam atha iti ucchate. So what is meant by the word atha is rupa prakrana anantaryam. Having completed the discussion of rupa, thereafter then we undertake the discussion of karma. So atha means thereafter. Says Bhashya, atha idanim sarva karma visheshanam manadarshanatmakanam chalanatmakanam cha kriya samanya matre antarbhava uchyate katham sarvesham karma visheshanam atma shariram samanyam atma atmanah karma iti uchyate atma atmanahi sharirena karma karodi ityuktam sharirecha sarva karma abhivyajyate. Atha means idanim, now then, sarva karma visheshanam of all specific karma that are performed, manana darshana atmakanam, karma actions are performed at the level of sense organs, at the level of mind, both. So manana means all the thinking etc. that takes place in the mind, darshanam, all the perception etc. that takes place at the level of sense organs, of all this karma. And then chalana atmakanam cha, and karma that involves chalanam, involves movement. The karmas performed at the organ of, at the level of organ of action. So chalanatmakam karma. So karma or action involving chalana movement is performed by the organs of action. And then darshanatmakam karma, the action of the level of perception is performed by the organs of perception. And mananatmakam karma, the karma of the nature of mananam, thinking, is performed at the level of mind. So all these specific actions being performed at these different levels. Kriya samanya matra antarbhava uchyate. Vashyakara says that now the next passage shows how all the specific karmas are included into what we call karma samanya, or again the principle of karma. Footnote number 5 said, Kriya samanya ikya mityatha. So the, all of them are not apart from kriya samanya, or the kriya in general, we can say principle of karma. Siddhanagri kriya visheshanam kriya mantre antarbhavam prasnadvara sporayati. That all the specific actions, kriya mantre antarbhavam, that all of them are included in the kriya mantra, meaning the principle of karma. Karma means action in general. Prasnadvara sporayati is clarified through a question, katham ityadina. So Vashyakara says, katham, how do you say that all the kriya visheshas are included in kriya samanya? Same thing, sarvesham karma visheshanam atma. So of all these specific karma, atma is uktam. Atma is the very cause. So says atma shariram. So by the word atma we should understand shariram, or the body. Says footnote number 6, nanu katham atma karmanam uktam iti visheshatah vyapadishyate. See, what atma, if it is understood in the conventional sense, atma means satchidananda atma, then the question is, how do you say that atma, that is satchidananda atma, is karmanam uktam iti, that it is the uktam or the cause of karma? Iti visheshatah vyapadishyate. Why should you say that atma is the cause of karma specifically? Tasya sarvopadanatvat iti, because atma is the upadana karana of the entire creation. Why do you say that atma is upadana karana merely of karma? Iti asankya atma shabdasamaha. So the meaning of the word atma is being stated. Atma shariram iti. So atma means shariram. Sharira vishaya atma shabdenatra tan nirvartyam karma samanyam lakshade. Even by the word sharira also is not meant just the body, but the karma as such that is performed by the body. So by the word chakshu was meant the eyes, but what is perceived by the eyes, namely the light. And so also by the word body, atma is meant of course body, and by the word body also is not meant just the body, but what is done by the body, namely the action in general. So karma samanyam. Then nirvartyam. So that which is accomplished by the body, this is karma samanyam lakshade. Iti pratikopadana purukamaha atma iti. And so asa karmanam atma. So that word atma, atma iti. Shariram. Tathacha vartikam. Vak chakshus shabdato yadvat grihyade visheshtayoho atmano visheshtadvat atma shabdena grihyade iti. Yadvat, just as vak chakshu shabdatah, by the words vak and chakshu, tayohu visheha grihyate. So by the word vak, we did not mean the organ of speech, but what the organ of speech does, namely the shabda samanyam. Or by the word chakshu, we meant not the eyes, but what the eyes perceive, namely the rupa samanyam. And so also by the word sharira, we do not mean sharira, but what the sharira does, namely the karma samanyam. Iti atmana visheha tadvat atma shabdena grihyate. Okay. So going back to Bhashya, sarvesham karmaviseshanam atma, atma means shariram, samanyam, because sharira, body, something that is involved in every karma. Without the body, karma cannot be performed. Therefore, it is called atma, atmanah karyam, atmanah karma iti uchyate. So atmanah sharirasya karma iti uchyate. And therefore, what is meant by atma is whatever is generally performed by the body, which is the karma samanyam. Atma shabdena sarira nirvartya karma grahane purushavida brahmana sesham anukulayati. Atma shabdena atra, here by the word atma, sarira nirvartya karma grahane. So, when you interpret the word atma as karma, that is generally performed by the body, purushavida brahmana sesham anukulayati. We can ask this question, how do you just all of a sudden say atma means shariram? So, purushavida brahmanam, that is the footnote number 11, it says what? Chaturtha brahmana. In the fourth brahmana, this is what is said. Atmana. So, Vashyakara quotes here, atmana hi sharirena karma karodhidhi uktam. Because that came earlier, you know. Atmana hi sharirena karma karodhidhi. My atma or body alone, one performs all the actions. So there, the word Atma was interpreted by Shruti herself as Shariram. So then says Tatreva Upapattim Aha. Tatreva. Atma Shabdita Deha Nirvarti Karamata Grahe. So when by what Atma you mean the Karamatram Upapattim Aha. Vashyakara says Sharirecha Sarva karma avivyajyate, because in the body alone all the karma manifests. And therefore, by the word body, we mean here the principle of karma, karma in general, karma samanyam. Sharirecha sarva karma avivyajyate. Again, says footnote number 9 on the same page, sarvam karma iti taduktam vartike. Sarvendriya parispandha vyajyate na sharirake. Sharira visheshtasmat atmetyatra vidhiyate iti. Sarvendriya parispandha. So sharira visheha tadjanya parispandha iti avada. So sarvendriya parispandha vyajyate na sharirake. All the movement of the indriyas, actually they only manifest at the level of body. Indriya, the sense organs are principles in themselves, but all the sense organs are able to function only at the level of body. What we call all the golakas, or all the places, or the centers rather. So centers where specific sense organs function are all centers located in the body. So faculty of seeing can function only through eyes, which are located in the body. Faculty of hearing through ears, again located in body. And therefore, all the activities performed by the various sense organs, sarvendriya parispandha vyajyate na sharirake. For us, so in our body alone, so na sharirake, in our body alone, all the activity of sense organs become manifest. Sharira visheha tasmat atma ityatra abhidhiyate. Therefore, sharira visheha tadjanya parispandhaiti. And therefore, whatever movement takes place at the level of body, is what is meant here by the word Atma. So that is Atma means Prakrita Vakya in this particular sentence. Yeah. Then going back to Anandagiri, Tathapi, Katham Atma Shabda hai, Sharira Nirvartyam Karma Bruyat, Iti Ashankya, Tathapi, Sharirasya Karma Nirvartakatvebi. Even though all the actions are performed at the level of body, all that accepted, even then, katham atma shabda hai, sharira nirvartyam karma bruya. See, what has happened is, what atma is first of all interpreted as body, and the body of the sharira is further interpreted as karma samanyam. So what atma is interpreted as karma samanyam. How do you stretch so far, you know? So tathabhi katham, even though all the actions are performed at the level of body, katham atma shabda hai, sharira nirvartyam karma bruya. How does the word atma actually say? It is karma performed by the body. Nityasanga lakshanaya ityasanga. It is by lakshanavrati. Ajahal lakshanavrati. The word atma means here the karma samanyam. Ataha. So Vashyakara says on page 412. अतः तात्स्थ्यात् तच्छब्दं कर्म कर्म सामान्यमात्रं सर्वेषामुत्थम् इत्यादि पूर्ववत् अतः therefore अतः इत्यादि ही Says footnote 1, Atma Shabditehasya Sarva Karma Janakatvat Sarva Karmanam Atma Shabdita Dehasthatvat Atma Shabdita Dehasya Sarva Karma Janakatvat. Because what is meant by, so Atma Shabdita Deha, so body which is what is referred to here by the word Atma, Sarva Karma Janakatvat, it is a body that actually produces all the karma. And it is body what is that is meant by the word Atma here. Sarva karmanam Atma sabdita dehastatva. Therefore, all the karmas are located or they have their locus in the body, which is what is referred to by the word Atma here. So Vashyakara said, Ataha tasthyat. See, the footnote continues, Ajahal lakshanaya Atma sabditam karma. So ajahal lakshana, ajahal lakshana, where you don't give the original word and add a word. So atma is there, but then you add the word karma, because tatsthyat. So tatsthyat means, since karma is performed by the body, so karma has its locus in the atma, now in the body. And therefore, we say that by the word body, is meant something related to the body, and that is karma. So, by sharira, word sharira is meant here, sharira nirvartyam karma. So, karma that is performed by the body. Or sharira abhivyajyam karma, karma that manifests at the level of body. Tadabhi karma samanyam atram ityasa, and that also is nothing but karma samanyam, the karma in general. Ataha tatsthyat, and since the karma is all located in the body, therefore by the word body is meant not only body, but then karma that is performed at the level of body. Like shono dhavati, the red runs. So then we, how to understand this statement? The red horse runs. So red is retained and the word horse is added. Because naturally red cannot run. And therefore you have to understand that the red horse runs. So this is called ajahal lakshana, where we don't give up the original word, but we bring in a new word which is related to the original word. You can't say red elephant runs because there is no such thing as a red elephant. So wherever the possibility of redness is there, that is brought in. And so also, abhaya word atma. Since atma cannot be directly, or body, cannot be directly the cause of the specific karma, so we have to say that karma samanyam is the cause of karma vishesha. Therefore, karma samanyam, which is the action performed by the body, is related to the body, and therefore, that is what is meant here by the word atma here. Tatshabdam karma, karma samanya matram, sarvesham uktam ityadi purvatam. Therefore, that karma samanya becomes the uktam, the material cause of the specific karma. And then the rest is understood like as before. See the Anandagiri then. Sankshepasyabhi, sankshepantramaha. So whole jagat is reduced to the three, nama, rupam and karma. These three are further reduced, you know. So, as you said, Sankshepa is provided in order that you can see things in a small perspective, in a limited way, not limited way, but in a very clear way. So, when a lot of discussion is there, when that lot of discussion is summarized, then you can see clearly what exactly is presented by the discussion. And that summary is further summarized so that what is to be conveyed becomes very clear. So, what is to be conveyed is that this is anatma and the heyam. And therefore, the vairagya is what the purpose of all the discussion is, to create vairagya. Although this purpose, this discussion, anyone should understand also. As we say, there are day-to-day activities in life. Seeing and hearing and whatever, and working, acting, etc. But at the same time, we are also made to see here how all of this is anatma and therefore falls in the category of Hayam. So saṅkṣepasyāpi, the footnote number 2, nāma rūpa karmātmanā saṅkṣeptasyāpi jagadaha punah saṅkṣepāntaram ityardaha. So first of all, the whole jagat was discussed, and that was summarized as nāma rūpam and karma. Tasya jagataha punah saṅkṣepāntaram, and that is that further summarized or further condensed. So these three are condensed into one, that is what is said here. Tadetadri. Says Bhashya, tadetada yathoktam namarupam karma trayam itaretara shrayam itaretara bhivyakti karanam itaretara pralayam samhatam tridanda vishtam bhavata sat ekam tadetat yathoktam namarupam karma. Yathoktam, what has been said here earlier, the name, form and karma. Trayam, this three, is actually one alone, because samhatam is always interconnected. In fact, this namarupa karma never three separate entities. You find them all of them together. You don't find them separately. Itaretara ashrayam. Each one depends upon the other. The nama depends upon rupa and the karma, and the rupa depends upon nama and karma, and karma depends upon nama rupa, because one requires the other two. One cannot be without the other two. Because when name is there, automatically rupa is there, because when you use the word ghata, automatically the object ghata or the rupa is always associated. And you cannot perceive ghata, or you cannot think of ghata, unless you also think of the function that ghata performs. When you think of ghata, automatically the water and whatever feeling of the water, etc., associated with ghata, always comes to your mind. So these three always come to the mind together. One brings the other two, because one cannot exist without the other two. So itaretar ashrayam, each one actually depends upon the other two. Itaretar abhivyakti karanam, and one brings to manifestation the other two. When we use the word ghata, automatically that word ghata brings also into manifestation the rupa ghata and the karya ghata also. So itaretara abhivyakti karanam, itaretara pralayam, in one the other two also resolve. Itaretara pralayam, in what we call nama, the rupa and karma also resolve. In rupa, the nama and karma also resolve. So the three can be reduced to one. Samhatam, and therefore it is always connected, interconnected with each other. Tridanda vishtam bhavat sat ekam. Tridanda vishtam bhavat, that the three sticks held it together. So three sticks can support, you know. After all, if you want to support things, then two cannot support them. Three are adequate, you know, to support. So how three sticks, each one supports the other two? That's a very beautiful example, you know. So tridanda vishtam bhavat, how three sticks support. So each one supports the other two, and each one is supported by the other two. You take away one, other two also disappear. That's why each one becomes the cause of pralaya of the other two, you know. So take away nama, the rupa and karma also disappear. That's how you can say that the rupa and karma have merged into nama. Take away rupa, the nama, karma also disappear, so the other two also disappear into that. So each one becomes the pralaya, itaretara pralayam, each one becomes the pralaya of the other two. And samhatam, they are always together. One cannot be without the two, and without the other two. So tridanda vishtam bhavat sat ekam. So even though all this is three, in reality it is one alone. So this jagat is reduced to this three, nama, rupa, karma, all of them are yet reduced to one alone. So saṅkṣepasyāpi saṅkṣepāntaram. Sri Anandagiri, tadetatrayam tridanda vishtam bhavat samhatam sat ekamiti sambandha. That all these three, tridanda vishtam bhavat samhatam, that it is like this three sticks, you know. So, you know, what you erect, you know, with the help of three sticks, in order to support something. So that is the Tridanda Vishtambha. And so, like that, Samhatam always connected to one another. Samhatam Sat Ekam. And therefore, these three being always connected to one another is really one alone. Iti Sambandha. Katham Samhatatvam. So, how do you say that? On the other two. So each one is a ashraya of the other two, and each one in turn depends upon the other two. Says Anandagiri, Rupam Visham Ashritya Nama Karmani Siddhyatah. Naturally, Rupa means an object. So Rupam Visham Ashritya. So taking the support of the refuge of the object, Nama Karmani Siddhyatah. The Nama and the Karma can only be possible when there is Rupa or an object. Svatantrena nirvishayoho tayoho siddhya darshanat. Without an object, the name cannot be there or the karma also cannot be there. So svatantrena nirvishayoho. Suppose there is no object pertaining to nama. Suppose there is nama, you know, gagabunga, but there is no object. Then the nama as well as karma really cannot have their existence unless there is a corresponding object. So that Vishaya, the object really, is what actually provides the existence to the Nama and Karma. And similarly, this is applicable to other combinations also. Nama Karmani cha Ashritya Rupam Siddhyati. But Vishaya also cannot be unless there is Nama and Karma. You can say, no, sometimes we may not even know what this object is and still it is there. How do you say that the object is dependent upon nama? In fact, we say it by the word nama, is meant the concept in our mind. And therefore, every object always creates a concept. Without a concept, an object cannot be. Anything that is created, it could not have been created unless it was first in a conceptual form. So, anything that is made here, that you perceive, is created necessarily. And before something is created, it must be in the mind in the conceptual form, otherwise it cannot come into manifestation. And it cannot be in the conceptual form, then it must be in the name first, because name is a concept in the mind, which becomes the rupa, or the form. And therefore, the rupa could not be there unless the nama was there. At the same time, a concept cannot be unless some function is involved. You cannot conceptualize something. You cannot make a glass, for example. You cannot make a tumbler unless you understand what the tumbler does. And so every concept also requires kriya or action or function. So therefore the concept cannot be unless function is, and the object cannot be unless the concept is. And that's why I say, nama karmani cha ashritya rupam siddhyati. And so object also can be, is only possible when nama and the karma are there. नहीं ते हित्वा किंचित उत्पद्यते इत्यर्थः. And therefore, without nama and karma, you cannot produce anything. It's amazing. You cannot produce anything unless you think about it in the mind. And you cannot think about something in the mind unless you think of what it is going to do. And therefore, unless karma is there, nama cannot be. Unless nama is there, rupa cannot be. इत्यर्थः. So before we proceed with that, let us take care of some footnotes which are there. Footnote number 3 on the page 412. Itaretar ashram iti visheshanasya tatparyam vadan. Itaretar ashram, so Anandagiri explained, itaretar ashram iti visheshanasya tatparyam vadan. Mahashayakara says itaretar ashram, that's what Anandagiri explained. Nama karma ashrayatvam rupasya pradarshayati. How rupa has its ashraya on nama and karma. So, Anandagiri said, rupam iti, rupam visham ashritya nama karmani siddhyatah. Taduktam vartike. Rupam eva pratishthasyat sarvada nama karmanoho. Rupa, an object, is always pratishtha, is always the basis for the nama and the karma. Because without an object, the name is no meaning and the karma also is not possible. Nahi rupamana ashritya vidyate nama karmani. Without the rupa, without taking the ashraya of the rupa, nama and the karma cannot obtain. So sarvada. Sarvada means sarvada nama karmano daihikayoho dvayoho sattva vachinna kale. So when the other two fellows are, the other two are there, this must always be there. Otherwise, the other two cannot be there. Tatritma nahi rumanashatya tayo asvatantya adityartha. Since other two are dependent, so other two are dependent upon rupa. Nama karma are dependent upon rupa. At the same time, the nama karmani cha asritya rupam siddhyati. Rupa also is possible only when nama karma are there. So nama karma are dependent upon rupa, and rupa is dependent upon nama karma. Then you can say nama rupa is dependent upon karma, and karma is dependent upon nama rupa. The rupa karma are dependent upon nama, and nama is dependent upon rupa karma. You can work it out, you know. So, but we say these three always go together naturally. So one, so you require each one to support the other. You take away one, other two go away. So that's a fantastic example, you know. So tridanda vishtambhava. You can see how the clarity here of supporting, you know. So each one depends upon the other. Itaretara ashram, itaretara abhivyaktika. Other two fellows can be there only when the third is there, you know. Anyway, itaretara pralayam, take away one, the other two also disappear. Samhatam, therefore they are always a sanghata, meaning all of these are one, so they form one unit. Anyway, okay. So going to end the nahi te hitva kinchit utpadyata ityartha. Ityartha again, oh, footnote number 8, that's a long one. So nahi te hitva kinchit utpadyata. Naturally, so without nam and karma, nothing can ever be produced, nothing can ever come into existence, that's what is meant. So, footnote number 8 on page 413, ityartha iti. Evam karmanah nam rupashtyatvam uktam vartika. So, in this manner, in the vartika it is said, how karma also depends upon nama and rupa. Prane eva pratishthayvam sadasyat nama rupayoho. Prane ka atmya sayad yasmat atmanabhas sadatayoho. Iti. So karma means prana. Again, karma is possible only when movement is there, shakti is there, prana is there. So prane evam pratishthayvam sadasyat nama rupayoho. Pratishthayvam. Prane eva pratishthayvam sadasyat rupana. Prane eva only in the prana alone. So, nama rupayoho pratishtha syat. So, name and form can be there only when prana is there. Prana ka atmya shreya jasmat atmanabhas sadatayoho. Only when the prana is there, then alone the rupa. So, only when activity is there, then vishaya can come into existence. So, you cannot produce something unless activity is there. To produce anything, you require action. And therefore, karma is required to produce when vishaya. In that sense also, karma, so vishaya or the rupa is dependent upon karma. And nama is, nama and rupa always go together. So how nama rupa are dependent upon karma? Because unless you do karma, the nama rupa cannot come into existence. Of course we said that if word karma is understood as function, now you cannot imagine nama rupa without a corresponding function. So says the Tika, eva meaning rupasya nama karma ashrayatvat ityartha. Just as rupa is dependent upon nama and karma, and so also nama rupa are dependent upon karma. Pranasya kriya samanyatmana nama rupa ashrayatva hitumaha pranayati. So prana means kriya samanyam, and that is a hetu for nama rupa. Nama rupayoho dehasthayoho sattvam sada pranadhin iti. Pranasya tadashvayatva upihityartha. Because name and form which are at the level of body, meaning at the level of vishaya, they are always dependent upon prana. Okay. Then namna rupadyashvayatam tahiyabhyuktam. Then again, nama is dependent upon rupa karma. Tadvat vagashvayatvam cha tayoho syad rupa karmanoho. So also rupa and karma, the vishaya as well as karma dependent upon speech. Vacha prakashyamanete prayujyate yatasada. Only when you utter a name, that an object is illumined. Otherwise it is not illumined. And therefore, it is speech that illumines name and karma. And thus each one illumines the other two, each one is illumined by the other two, each one is responsible for the other two, is dependent upon the two. These three are always intertwined. rupasya karmasya pratyegam itaretra ashrayatvavat vakshabdasya namatra sarupadayasvadama vachayati. Nahi rupasya karmanasya prakashitasya kvachit viniyoga. Namely, rupa and the karma or visha and the karma, unless they are illumined by name, it is not possible that kvachit viniyoga, that they can be, have any use at all. Tena prakashayoho tayoho yuktam prakash prakashak prakashaka ashrayatvam. Therefore, the rupa and the karma are illumined by the word. So, word illumines a form and illumines also the action. And only when the word illumines them, that alone you come to know about them and then alone you can use them. So, they would have any kind of usefulness only when they are illumined by a word. There may be millions of things in the world actually, but they are not useful to us unless we know that they are there. How do you know that they are there? Only when they are illumined by a noun or name. So in this we can think how each one is dependent upon the other two and how the other two are dependent upon each one. It's an exercise, you know, that Vatvikara does in detail. But Anandagiri also says that Vachakena Vachyasya Tena Itarasya Tabhyanta Kriyayaha Taya Tayoho Apekshadarsanat Anyonyam Abhivyanjakatvam. Each one also becomes Abhivyanjaka or responsible for the manifestation of the other two. Vachakena Vachyasya. Vachya is what? Vishaya, Adarupa. And Vacha means what? Nama. So Nama is responsible for the manifestation of Rupa. Tena Itarasya. Again, that Vishaya also. When you see a part, then alone the name is also, it comes to your mind. And that way, the Rupa also becomes the becomes the cause for manifestation of Nama. That's footnote number 9. In Vachakasya, okay. Tabhyamcha Kriyayaha. And this Vachya and Vachaka Nama Rupa bring to manifestation Kriya. Taya Tayoho Apeksha Darsana. The Kriya in turn again brings to manifestation the name and form, because when you do something, then alone something can be produced. So name and form can be brought to manifestation only when you do something. So Kriya brings to manifestation name and form. The Nama brings to manifestation Kriya and the Rupa. The Rupa brings to manifestation Nama and the Kriya. So each one becomes what? Anyonya Itaretra Abhivyakti Karanam. Each one is responsible, each one is dependent upon the other. Each one is also responsible for the manifestation of the other. So Satta and Sphurti. Each one provides Satta to the other two. Each one provides Abhivyakti or the manifestation to the other two. So each one becomes a Satta Sphurti Pradata, Pradatru. So it is said, itaretara abhivyakti karanam. Then also says, itaretara pralayam. How each one becomes also pralaya. When one is not there, the other two cannot be. Therefore, the other two also merge into one. Says Anandagiri, satinamni rupa samhara darshanat rupechasi nama samhara dushtehe satoshyatayoho karmanah tasminshasati tayoho upasamharopalambhat itaretara pralayam ityaha. Satinamni rupa samhara darshana. You find that the name remains ghata and the object ghata goes away, still the name remains. Rupa echatati nama samhara duste. Name is forgotten very often, the rupa remains. Satos satayoho, both of them can be there. Karmanaha tatasmin karmanaha samhara duste. Nama rupa is there, but the karma goes away. Tasmin sasati, when karma is there, tayoho upa samhara, the name and form are not. Iti upalambhavat. Itaretar pralayam. Anyway, what we are saying is, take away one and the other two cannot remain. That's what it is. Take away one stick, the other two cannot remain there. So take away nama, the rupa and the karma cannot remain. Take away rupa, nama, karma cannot remain. In that sense, it is easy to understand how one becomes a pralaya. One becomes a very cause of merger of the other two. So itaretar pralayam. Samhatam tridanda vishtamavat sada ekam, rasat ekam. Even though it is three, in fact it is one alone. This is footnote number 1. Samhatam, sammilitam. They are always connected to each other or joined with each other, mixed with each other. Uktam vartike ashrayashray bhavena nam rupak kriyatmata. Ekarthanam satamtesham samhatisya shrinake. Ashraya ashray bhavena. Since each one is ashraya of the other two, Nam Rupa Kriyatmanam, all these three, each one is ashraya of the other two. Ekarthanam Satam Tesham, you cannot say that there are three. In fact, they are one alone. Samhadishya Sharirake, there we can say that all of them find their samhadi, or all of them find their assembly in this one thing called Atma or the body. Footnote number 2. So Tridanda, that's okay. Ashraya Sri Bhavena Avasthanavat. Right. No, Anandagiri says, Trayanam Ekatvam Viruddham Shankitva Pariharti. How can the three be one? Trayanam Ekatvam Viruddham. You say that these are three and they are three are as one alone. How can you call it three and then say it, they are one? So, Kena Ityadina, Bhashyakara says, Ashankya Shankitva Pariharti. First Shankha and then the Parihara. Says Bhashyakara, Kena Atmana Ekatvam Iti Uchyate. Kena Atmana, in what form they are one? In how do you say that they are one? Kena Atmana. Although these three are called three, then what manner they are said to be one? Iti, if this is a question, Uchyate, this Shruti herself replies that.
Ayam Atma, Ayam Pindaha, Karya Karana Atma Sanghataha, Tatha Annatraye Vyakhyataha, Etanmayova Ayam Atma Ityadina.
All these three ultimately merge into one alone, so all these three are one alone. I am Atma, meaning this Sanghata. I am Atma, I am Pindaha. This Pinda, meaning this individual Upadhi. Karya Karanatma Sanghata. This Sanghata, the Upadhi, consisting of Karya and Karana, the body, the sense organs and whatever, this physio-physical, psycho-complex is really, all these three have, they are merging into this one alone. Says footnote number 3, Karyeti, Pratyaksha Upalabdha Karyakarana Sanghata Atmana Trayanam Ekatmaniti Yavata. So Pratyaksha Upalabdha Karyakarana Sanghata Atmana. In the nature of, in the form of this Karyakarana Sanghata, which is evident to us, these three are one alone. So all of these three find their oneness in this Karyakarana Sanghata. Dehasya Trayatmatvam na kevalam pratyaksham vakyam api bhavah. Not only do we find that karya, nama, rupa and karma, all of them obtain the body, but the Shruti also says, so karya karanatma sanghatah. Again, the footnote number 4, tatha iti. So karya karana sanghatah yathoktat trayatmakah tatha annatraye tat prakane etan mahityadina vyakhyate namah. So how do you say that? Karyakarana Sanghata is this three. That was said there, in that place there. Tat prakarane etanmaya ityadana vyakhyataha. So, 153, go back to page 355, then you can find this. Page 355, then the last line, etanmayo va ayamatma vangmayo manomaya pranamaya. Etanmayova ayamatma. So this body actually is made of these three. Vangmaya, Brahmanomaya, Pranamaya. Of the nature of speech, the mind and the prana. That's what this body or this upadhi consists of. And therefore, Vashyakara said, Tatha annatre vyakhyataha. Tatha, in that manner in fact, that this body is this three, Vangmaya meaning Vag, Manomaya meaning Manaha, and Pranamaya. So Vag means the Nama. Then Manomaya is what? The Rupa. And then Pranamaya is Karma. So that's what was said there also. So we find it also so, and the Shruti also so. Vakyam. Vakyam is what? The Shruti Vakya also says that, plus Pratyaksha. We find it to be so in our own experience. Sri Dhananagiri, Nam Rupa Karmanam, Karya Krana Sanghata Matra Prebi, Tataha Vyatariktam Sanghata Adanyasya Adhyashankaya. All right?
Nam Rupa Karmanam Sankarikana Sanghata Matratvevi.
That Nam Rupa Karma, all of them are included in Karikana Sanghata.
Tataha Vyatiriktam Sanghata Danyasyat.
But then, other than Sanghata, also something can be there.
Iti Asankaha Etavat.
So Vashyakara says,
Etavad dhidam sarvam vyakratam avyakratam cha yaduta nama rupam karma iti atma u ekoyam karyakarana sanghata sanna adhyatma adibhuta Atidayo bhavena vyavastitam etadevatrayam namarupam karmeti
etavadvidam sarvam vyakratam avyakratam cha. There is nothing other than this three namarupa karma. In all the namarupa karma, nothing but this upadhi. And therefore,
etavadvidam sarvam vyakratam avyakratam cha.
The manifest and unmanifest, whatever there is in this creation, is this much alone, that's all.
Yaduta nama rupam karma.
What was said as nama rupa karma is nothing but vyakrata and avyakrata, and all those three are nothing but this pinda alone.
And also, I am atma, atma means atma u. So footnote number 6, deha, I am atma deha, u means api, I am atma api. I am deha api, ekaha.
So also this pinda is one.
But I am karyakana sanghataha san,
even though this body is one, it is also three.
Adhyatma, adhibhuta, adhidaiva bhavena vyavasitam.
This body that obtains the individual, elemental and the cosmic level.
So this body, etadevatrayam nam rupam karmaidhi.
So this body obtaining at the adhyatma, adhibhuta, adhidaiva level. Also is the three, nama, rupa and karma. Those three are one and one alone is three. That means the whole creation is reduced to the three and that three are reduced to this one alone, upadhi.
Namaditre sanghat matratve katham vyavahar asankaram iti asankyaha.
If you say that all this nama, rupa, karma are all nothing but sanghat matratve and nothing but the sanghat of the upadhi,
katham vyavahar asankaryam.
How is it possible that specific vyavahar can be performed? If all the three are merged into one, how do you specifically use nama, rupa and the karma? Those distinctions will be all lost. So how this distinct vyavahar is possible?
So nama adinam vyavahar asankaryam bhinvatvena vyavaharam.
This is nama, this is rupa, this is karma. How can you say when all of them are one alone, how can you actually use them or how can you understand them as separate from each other?
Iti asankya hai, atma iti, whatever that is. So atma u ekoyam karyakarana sanghata hai, so that atma inspired of being one is this three, nama, rupa and the karma. Says Anandagiri, sanghatoyam atma shabdita hai, swam ekopisan adhyatma adivhedena sthitam trayameva bhavati iti vyavahara sankarimiti bhavaha.
So this pinda, in spite of being one, adhyatma then obtaining at this three level, adhyatma, adhibhuta, adhidaiva, trayameva bhavati,
namrupa, karmatmakam eva bhavati iti na kinchit na vyavahara asankaryam. So bhavati, footnote number 13, bhavati iti ekasyeva dehasya, not srutaha but kutaha, Trirupatvam.
How can one body be Trirupam, threefold iti ahu, ataha ahu vartike?
Nam rupa kriya bhinno dehoyam grushyate yataha iti. So nam rupa kriya bhinna dehoyam grushyate yataha.
So stika, namadi bhinnasya dehasya grushyamanatva dityartaha.
Because in deha itself you find nama, rupa and the karma all the three.
In deha itself you find the nama rupa, namadi bhinnasya dehasya grushyamanatvad,
namadi vyatirekena tasya grushyamanatvad yavata.
Meaning this body also cannot be perceived without all these three, name, form and karma.
Or namarupa kriya abhinna hai chedetu sarala yojana.
So namarupa kriya abhinna hai dehoyam grushyate yadaha.
Since
This deha is always underseen as always associated with all the three, nama, rupa and karma. Bhinna shabdasya sambhinna arthatvedu sarvatara iti dastavyam. So bhinna means sambhinna. So tathacha vana vrukshavat samudaya vivaksha ayam deheti vivaharaha. Samudaya vivaksha tu aparataha iti tat asankarim rabhipatya iti vivahar asankarim iti. And so vana vrukshavat samudaya vivakshaya ayam deha iti vyavahara. Ayam deha includes all the dehas actually. Like sometimes the vruksha may be referred to as vanam, or vanam may be referred to as vruksha. So one body includes all the bodies, and that includes all the nama, rupa and the karma. In short, if you understand one, you understand the whole creation. The idea is, whole creation is nama, rupa, karma. And all the nama, rupa, karma find their total expression in one body. If you understand this one body properly, you understand the creation. The manifest creation can be understood when you understand this one body, because the body includes within itself nama, rupa and karma. Understand one nama, you understand all the nama. Understand one rupa, meaning understand the truth of one nama, you understand the truth of all the namas. Understand one rupa, you understand the truth of all the rupas, and kriya, all the kriyas. So all you have to do is, in order to understand the creation, understand there is nama, rupa, karma. To understand that, understand this pinda properly and see how, whatever it is, how limited it is and how in what manner it is anatma. And that's how, this body being anatma, one should not be identified with it, and the whole creation also is represented by the body, therefore one should not be identified with that. And that is how the vairagya is created from the world. Because trying to examine individual objects and trying to discover vairagya from them will be infinite, will never happen. So this is statistics. That you see them, the group behavior is seen there. You find some common features. So whole universe is a group. What's the common feature? Nama, rupa and karma. And where do you find all these three obtaining? In the body. So those three are one alone, and this one is three alone. You understand one, you understand all the three, because all the three are actually, all of them are located in one alone. Although those three make up this one, and this one makes up the three. So understand one atom, you understand the whole creation. Understand the truth of it properly. That's how, to make it simple, all of this is reduced to one alone, namely, this pinda karya karana sanghata. So how that is anatma, how it is desha kala parichinnam, how it is anitya, how it is jada, how it is anatma, how it is dukkhatmaka, how it is heya. Yadviritam tad alpam martyam dukkhatmakam heyam. And so anything that is known here is alpa, is limited. Martya, limited means subject to time. Then dukkhatmakam, cause of dukkha, if you identify with it. Otherwise nothing creates dukkha. But if I identify with it and call it atma, then dukkhatmakam. Heyam, when you say the body is to be given up, means what? Only atma buddhi in the body is to be given up, that's all. Nothing can be given up because nothing belongs to me anyway. But then what is to be given up is the notion that I entertain about a thing, that's all that is to be given up. So notion I entertain about the body is that it is atma. Or notion I may entertain about the objects of the world is that they are a source of happiness and security and so forth. All those notions are to be given up, then you have given up the world. Because you did not have the world to begin with, you thought that you had it. So similarly, when I call this object as mine, this pen is mine, it's merely my own notion that the pen is mine, was not mine to begin with. I don't have to give up the pen. Because I can give up the pen and still retain the notion mindness and it doesn't go. And give up the notion mindness. And then it is given up because it was always given up. I thought that it belonged to me, that's all. And so the thing doesn't. Meaning that mamatva or that mindness is merely a notion. It's a wonderful, it's an amazing notion, you know. Everybody is born with that. And how we extend the notion to a variety of things. And so mine, mine, mine. All that is to be given up. And that's what binds me. Moment I call this place mine, that's it. Then I'm bound. You know, to see every corner, you know, who is coming, who is going, where. Otherwise you don't bother. You visit many ashrams, you know, many places. You may bother about the security arrangement, the lighting, this arrangement. But here, you have to bother about everything, you know. This moment you identify with it, or you connect yourself with something, then it is a burden on your head, naturally. And that's how. What is to be given up is not that you walk out of a given place, then you have given it up. Maybe you may want to walk out if you want to, but merely an action is not giving up, that's all. Walking out or walking in, he is not giving up. It is giving up the notion about it, that this is mine. Oh, this is a source of security. That notion is what is to be given up. So that is what is meant by vairagya. Nothing, you know. Other things we cannot give up. We give up because other things we don't have. All that we possess are this notion. That's a private property. Nothing else we possess. Nothing else is created by us. Everything is created by God. So whoever is the author, Swami says, whoever is the author is the owner. Who can be the owner? Whoever is the author. If I author something, I can be the owner. I may say that I have authored this house and I have authored this clock. I have made it. But you could not have made it unless all the components were there. And you could not have made it unless there was the potential of making it. But you cannot make what the thing doesn't have the potential of. So you cannot make idli out of sand, regardless of what you do. So if you make idli out of that batter, out of the rice and what not, what's the wonderful thing about that, you know? Because anybody can make it. So, what is it? Polu cheta vagyutama karitasi kari gari. Samilu vagadata hum janu ke tu shana cheta. This is very interesting. So this man, this rich man is there, but a very miserly person, will never, you know, part with a single penny. But since he was very wealthy, therefore some fellow came expecting some, you know, something from him. So he came and made a performance. He had a tanpura. And so this fellow sang very well, you know, in tanpura. He played his tanpura very beautifully. So after 45 minutes of performance, then the performance was concluded. Then that fellow said, Shred the king, apo, you know, polu se the polu, tama kari taisi kari kari. Now poli was to bole, ma kari usha. What is the kari kari, you know? What have you done? Sambelu vagare to jamu ke tu shama se. So if you can really produce sound out of sambelu, Muslim, you know, then I say that's why, get, you have done something. And so whatever we create, we are able to create because that potential of creation is there. Nobody can create something of which the potential is not present. And therefore, even when we say that we have created something, we have created from the material which was already there, raw materials or components, and there too the possibility of that creation was there in its components, and therefore, all that we have created is a notion that this is my creation. That notion is my creation. Nothing else is my creation. And all that is to be given up is that notion. That's simple. And so, but not simple also. In order that thus, this vairagya, you know, that the jagat is reduced in this manner, so that by analyzing one, you analyze the whole creation. And thus, whatever kind of relationship you arrive at with this body, you can arrive at the whole creation. Okay, I am in the last paragraph on the page 414. Ekasminapi sanghate karyakaranarupena avanta vibhagamaha. Ekasminapi sanghate, in the one sanghata also, so karyakaranarupena. That's just one paragraph is left, you know, and so Karya Karana Rupena. As Karya and Karana, Avantara Vibhagamaha, the Avantara Vibhagam. The secondary division is again said by this Shruti. So Karya Karana, Karya Karana Vibhavata. So Karya, in this Sanghata again is made up of Karya and Karana. So Avantara Vibhagese Tadetaditi. So body is Karya, and prana is karanam. That's how the avanta vibhaga is given here. That's how. Bhashya says, tade tata vakshamanam. Says footnote 1, pranatmakam sautram shariram ityartha. That this sharira is pranatmaka. Prana is atma of this sharira. Sautram shariram. Prajapati is sharira. You know, he is nothing but his atma is prana. Says Bhashya further, amrutam satyena channam ityetasya vakyasya arthamaha. Amrutam satyena channam. That's what Shruti says, and the Shruti explains her vakyam. Amrutam, immortal, satyena channam. The immortal is hidden or covered by satya. Amruta is covered by satya. That's what it means. Iti etasya vakyasya arthamaha. Shruti gives the meaning of that vakya. Says Bhashya further,
प्राणो वै अमृतम् करणात्मकः अन्तः उपस्तम्भकः आत्मभूतः अमृतः अविनाशी
प्राणो वै अमृतम् प्राण इज लिंगात्मा दैट इज अमृतम् करणात्मकः प्राणः सो व्हाट वी कॉल द सटल बॉडी इज रिफर्ड हियर बाय द वर्ड प्राण अंतरुपस्तंभक है सो अंतस्सन उपस्तंभक है अंतस्सन धारक है द प्राण इज दैट विच इनसाइड द बॉडी एंड दैट विच सस्टेन्स द बॉडी देयरफॉर इट इज कॉल्ड आत्मा आत्मभूत है इट इज द वेरी आत्मा और द सेल्फ ऑफ द बॉडी अमृत है द बॉडी डाइज विद आत्मा दैट प्राण डज नॉट डाई अविनाशी एंड देयरफॉर इट इज कॉल्ड अमृत द प्राण इज कॉल्ड अमृत हियर अविनाशी Because it does not die even when the body dies. And prana is the very self of the body and sustains the body. Remaining inside, it sustains the body.
So, avinashi sthula dehe gacchati abhi yavan mokshan na gacchati ityartha.
Even though these bodies, sthula bodies keep on coming and going, the subtle body does not go away, does not die until moksha takes place. In that sense, the subtle body of the prana is said to be amrita or avinashi.
Then satyatyaccha bhavata
satyam. The word satya is said to be made of sat and tyak, become satya.
Satyatyaccha satyam bhutapanchakam.
So in Taittiriya Upanishad we say, we saw that satyatyaccha bhavata sat and tyak. Sat is manifest, tat is unmanifest. So these three elements, the fire, water and earth are called sat. And the two elements, akash and vayu, are called tyat, because you don't see them. And so, sat and tyat themselves make up what? The five elements and the whole creation. So, satchat yatcha satyam bhuta panchakam. So, what satya is understood as? Five elements, sat and tyat. Tadatmake, naam, rupa, and all the names and forms are made up of five elements. So, body also is made up of the five elements. All the names and forms are made of five elements. So, names and forms are called satya. What is satya? Sat and tyat. What is sat? The three elements, fire, water and earth. What is tyat? The two elements, the akasha and the vayu. And so, satya means five elements, which make up the name and form. So, name and form are called satya. The prana is called amrita, because avinashi. In spite of the gross body dying, the prana does not die until the moksha takes place. So, prana is called amrita, and this body which is namarupa, made of five elements, is called satya.
So says Bhashyakara, Naam Rupe Satyam Karyatmake Shariravasthe Kriyatmakastu Pranah Tayoho Upashtambakah. So Naam Rupe Satyam.
Satya also means Karmaphala. So karyatmake, satya also means karmaphala. Tadaitat satyam. You know, karma always gives rise to karmaphala. So it's called ritam also. So nama rupe satyam karyatmake. Nama rupa always of the nature of karya or the product. Shariravasthe located in the body.
Kriyatmakastu pranaha tayoho upastambakaha.
The prana which of the nature of kriya is upastambakaha, is dharaka, is that which sustains the body, that is nama rupa.
So tayoho nama rupayoho dharakah. So karana yathatmyam kathayati. So what does kriyatmaka does? Okay. Sri Anandagiri, panchigar panchama bhutatmakam tat karyam sarvam satchat yachayati vitpattehe satyam vairajam shariram.
We say that sat and tyat means the five elements. So panchigrita panchama bhutatmakam tat karyam sarvam. So all the five elements and elementals that are produced from the combination of the five elements, all of that is included in the word satya. Meaning the whole creation made up of the five elements, which is the gross, cosmic gross body, what we call the dvairajam shariram, the sharira of virat. That is called virat, meaning the whole cosmos.
Karyam apanchikrita panchamabhuta tat karyatmaka karana rupa saptadashaklingasya Sutrakshasya Ayatanam.
What is prana? Is subtle body. Subtle body is made up of 17 elements. 5 organs of perception, 5 organs of action, 5 pranas, buddhi and manah. And these are made up of the five apanchikrata panchamabhuta, meaning all these tattva-bodha. Made up of what we call the five subtle elements, and that totality of that makes up what we call sutra-atma, Hiranyagarbha. And Hiranyagarbha, for Hiranyagarbha, Virat becomes a body or ayatanam. So this sthula sharira is the ayatanam, is a place or is abode. No, so this nam-rupa becomes the abode of the prana. Nam-rupa becomes the abode of the prana. So prana sustains the nam-rupa, nam-rupa becomes the abode of prana. Tasyeva achadakam. So actually this nam-rupa, that is body, covers that prana, achadakam. Because prana is contained in the body. Body is the abode of the prana, so prana is covered by the body. Tatkhalu anatmabhi sthuldeha chinnatvat durvijnanam. Even though prana is anatma, sukshma is anatma, still it is inspired, because of its being covered by the gross body, therefore durvijnanam. Yenabhi chinnam pratyek vastu sutaram. And the atma which is even concealed by the prana. See, the gross body conceals or covers the prana, therefore the sukshma sharira. So sukshma sharira becomes very difficult to understand because it is not evident. So about the mind, etc., all is very difficult to understand things because it is not evident. Then prana is even covered by the sukshma sharira. Then what to talk of is difficulty. You know, that prana is durvijnaya, or extremely difficult to know what to talk of that. So pratyek vastu sutaram durvijnayam ita jnane avahitai bhavyam iti bhavaha. And therefore, that's the reason why one should always devote oneself to the knowledge of atma. Then prana, the sukshma sharira, is so difficult to know because it is covered by the body. Then what to talk of atma that is yet covered by the sukshma sharira? And therefore, one should always value the knowledge of atma. Iti. So Bhashyakara said in the Bhashya, we have to read that Vakya. Bhashyabhyam Shariratmakabhyam Upajana Apaya Dharmibhyam Martyabhyam Channaha Aprakashikritaha. So this prana, which is sukshma sharira, is channaha, is covered. Aprakashikritaha. Therefore it is prevented from being manifest. Prana or sukshma sharira is prevented from being perceived because it is covered by the gross body. And what is this gross body? Bhashyabhyam Shariratmakabhyam. By this name and form, which is external and made up, making up the body. Upajana Apaya Dharmibhyam, which are subject to growth and decay, Sankocha, Vritti Sankocha. Martyabhyam, both of them are martya. So Vinashvara Namrupabhyam, both these are mortal. So name and form which are subject to this death, by the name and form which is body, this prana, the subtle body, is covered and made very difficult to know. And prana in turn covers the atma, makes it even further difficult to know. Says Vashyakara, Anandagiri, Idanim Avidya Karya Prapancha Upasamhrati. Now the prapancha which is avidya karyam upasamhrati is now Bhashyakara concluded, summarizes there etaditi. Says Bhashya, etadeva samsara sattvam avidya vishayam pradarshitam. Etadeva samsara tattvam avidya vishayam pradarshitam. This is samsara tattvam. Etadeva karya, etadeva means what? Karya karana iti avata. No. Dehadvayatmano na upasamhritam. So dehadvaya is what? Subtle body and gross body. So this subtle body and the gross body together makes up the entire samsara. Samsara sattvam, samsara swarupam. Samsara is this body, which in turn is made up of the gross and the subtle. Where the gross is nama rupa, subtle is prana, and the gross covers the subtle and makes it difficult to know, and that is what the samsara, entire samsara, consists of. Avidya vishayam, avidya karyam, both are the product of ignorance. Pradarshitam, this is how the Shruti has shown how the entire creation, reduced to nama rupa karma, reduced to this pinda, and again looked upon as the consisting of growth and subtle bodies. He is nothing but the entire samsara, product of ignorance, avidya karyam. Therefore, heyam. How is it to be discarded? By vidya. So understand that we must know this. What is meant by discarding? Or what is meant by tyaga? What is meant by renunciation? All along there is renunciation of ignorance. Inasmuch as the whole creation is a product of ignorance, it is by knowledge alone that you can renounce it. In no other way you can renounce it. Everything is a product of ignorance, so the only way to renounce it is by knowledge, not by karma. You always associate karma with renunciation. By